Okay, so I'm gonna do finish game playthrough. I've already done the initial story and have gone to Dead Zone to up my level to 20. Completed some of the campaigns, avoided any milestones, collected all my tokens and turned it in to Devrin. So now I have 193. Now, I like to have usually one hand cannon and one scout rifle. But for my power weapon, I like to have a rocket launcher or a sniper. I'm kind of a sniper person. I don't like to run into things. I actually just like to sit back and pick everybody off. Kind of thin out the crowd before I start going in there. Alright, so I'm gonna sign on. Let's go with this. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna go to the next mission, which is gonna be on Titan. Right here.
Hawthorne already believes Zavala abandoned her and the survivors. Now that we're leaving, if we stayed, yes, we could help them survive, but if Zavala really is building a counteroffensive on Titan, we can save them all and take back the city. I have a bad feeling about this. The gravity on Titan is approximately 1.352 meters per second squared, except here. These floating rocks must be a residual effect from some hive magic. It's a cocoon of some kind. The life inside it isn't hive exactly. This could be how the hive's symbiont worms grow. Okay, Sloan, we can see the control center.
Copy that. Keep pushing forward. Commander, at this rate, we can start planning our counteroffensive. We'll be outside the city gates in no time.
it were only that simple.
If it only was.
It looked like the Hive were performing some kind of ritual. We should talk to Ikora. She knows all there is to know about Hive magic.
No one has seen Ikora or Cade since the city fell.
There's the control center.
Clear the area so we can move in.
fallen antenna. The fallen houses each used to have their own unique encryption, but now the codes they're using are all variants of the House of Kings. Made it, Sloan.
Perfect. Recon the perimeter before you move on the control center.
So it looks like we're standing in some kind of hive breeding ground.
Take it out.
Broken servitor. These parts are extremely valuable. The hive corrosion must be really bad for the Fallen to abandon it like this. Shoot the yellow sacks. We cleared the nest. Heading to the control center now.
Well done. Sweep the perimeter and we'll move in on your signal.
Thank you. From this console, a Golden Age technician locked down the shipyard and forbade all future arrivals. The entire arcology was undergoing an emergency evacuation. She signed off. I wonder if she made it out. Commander, it's done.
Copy that. Zavala and I are inbound. We're approaching the landing platform. Get up here and take a bow.
I didn't dare believe. If the light can find its way back to you, then perhaps there is hope for us all. Our numbers will continue to dwindle. We can no longer protect ourselves, much less the survivors. And without the light, are we even guardians anymore?
Commander.
We won't last long with dead generators. Wave energy converters power this station, but thanks to the Hive, they're in need of attention.
We can take care of it.
Yes, I believe you can.
All right, we're not out of this yet. Now that we've reached the control center, we still need to power up the place before we can take care of our fleet. Commander Zavala tells me you've volunteered. I'll run tactical. Shipwright Holiday here will provide tech support. It's a straightforward op. Get in, flip a switch, get out. Sloan's got a way of making things sound easy, doesn't she?
Yep.
Did we lead the Fallen here?
No. Those vultures have been following us since we evacuated Earth.
The Fallen depend on their servitors to provide a substance called ether. But this one's been picked clean of ether and abandoned. Sloan, Amanda, the Hive have infected everything.
Holiday, we gotta get you back in the air. We'll need ongoing aerial threat assessments to keep our perimeter secure.
Oh, yeah. You know my ship took a beating during the evacuation.
I'll bump you to the front of the line for repairs once the lights are back on.
Great. Great.
We can see the wave energy converters from here.
Sweet. Now just flip the switch and turn them on.
Accessing systems now.
Some of the pistons are moving, but we're still sitting in the dark.
Something went wrong. Pistons must be jammed.
Sorry, pal. But you're gonna have to go out there. Rig a workaround.
Looks like the Fallen tried to chain it closed. A for effort, guys, but I'm not sure this is how we're going to beat the Hive. Did you hear that? we've made it to the converter platforms.
Okay. Get to the stalled pistons. See what's jamming them. Once they're all moving, we're in business.
Oh yeah, found the problem. The Hive have gunked up the pistons.
Then let's find a fix.
First piston's good to go. We gave it a power scrubbing.
That's great and all, but, it's still pretty dark on this end. Sounds like you got more scrubbing to do, Guardian.
Final piston is clear.
Control center's still dark, so it's gotta be more than a piston problem. I have to get in futz with the circuit breakers.
Try the central platform. Everything routes through there.
Circuit breaker is going to be around there somewhere. Find it and flip the switch, just like I said. Power's back! Exemplary work, everyone. But we still have to deal with these intercepted enemy transmissions.
It's a hell of a view, isn't it? We're up and running, thanks to you. There's plenty more to do around here, though. Chief among them, finally breaking ground on a counter-offensive against the Red Legion. I have a plan, but it won't work without you. We intercepted a Priority 1 Red Legion signal during the city evacuation, but we can't crack the encryption. Holiday says there's tech that can do the job in the Arcology, which is effectively hostile territory. You'd be going in blind. The place has been dark for centuries. All we know for sure is the Hive is raising hell down there, perhaps literally. But if you're in, let's put the plan into action. I agree, but I think they take the news better coming from you.
Fallen thieves headed in your direction.
They hit us and ran. We lost tools, gear. My crews can't work without that stuff.
Thank you.
My crews will be reinforcing this rig again in no time.
Those fallen you tracked? We've located the rest of the gang. They're consolidating stolen Golden Age tech. In a nice big pile. Out in the open.
Give those thieves a taste of their own medicine.
I think that's the stash. Let's clear the area for transmat.
Good job. I'll set up a transmat. Wait a minute. Where's my beacon?
Did the Fallen steal your transmat beacon too?
Sloane has stepped aside for a moment. The thing she's shouting would blister your ears. May I recommend finding that beacon?
Does that Fallen look like a transmat beacon thief to you? He looks like a transmat beacon thief to me. that one. That one's gotta be a Transmat Beacon thief. He looks even thiefier than the first one. Area's clear. Let's get back to that stash so I can send it over.
Thank you.
You've cleaned them out. These components are critical to the rig's structural integrity. And thanks to you, we've got the tools to put them back.
Whatever the fallen steal, we steal back.
While I cannot condone theft, I do appreciate payback. Well done.
A Golden Age console. And a user is still logged in. Leilani Valero, Marine Tech number 426. She was in the middle of logging an emergency of some kind. This system used to detect underwater vessels looking to dock here at the shipyard. That's strange. It still works, and it's picking something up. Something below us, and very, very big. Thank you.
All ears. We'll be fine. Just fine.
Give me a file dump on Dredge and Yor. I know. Lockout override Sloan 35 Blue Alpha. Drop me the files and reach the buffer. Power plug. What?
Okay, well, those ships aren't going to fix themselves.
Amanda, that last drop ended up in the water. Get your pilots coordinating wind conditions.